Tonight, we're following some intriguing developments that may involve North Korea's Kim Jong Un. Let's go to CNN's Brian Todd. Brian, could the North Korean leader be on the move?
He could be on the move as we speak, Wolf, getting new information tonight that Kim could be on a train which pulled out of Pyongyang somewhat mysteriously in the overnight hours. There are indications he's headed to a meeting with his top ally to get a customary briefing before he likely meets with President Trump.
On the eve of his birthday, North Korea's ambitious and brutal dictator Kim Jong Un appears headed to a crucial meeting with his chief ally, China, as he prepares for a possible second summit with President Trump. South Korean media reports a distinctive armored train like this one left Pyongyang in North Korea for Beijing, China in the middle of the night, with at least one newspaper reporting Kim was on board. CNN could not independently confirm the reports. But if Kim was on board, analysts say it would be in keeping with Kim's complicated, often testy relationship with Chinese President Xi Jinping, including previous secret train trips to China for the two men to meet.
It is a little bit like a mafia leader going to see the big Don before a meeting of the consigliere or the other Dons, not because he loves Xi Jinping. In fact, all indications have been that Xi Jinping and Kim Jong Un hate each other, despise each other.
Love or hate, experts say Kim knows he needs the Chinese leader to keep goods flowing across the border between the two countries to sidestep sanctions. And Xi wants Kim to keep the dialogue with the United States going.
It's a great honor to have President Moon of South Korea with us.
Believing it's in China's interests for Kim to drive a wedge between the American president and U.S. allies South Korea and Japan. All of this, analysts suggest, could signal a second Trump-Kim summit sooner rather than later.
We're negotiating a location. It will be announced probably not in the not-too-distant future.
Tonight, there is growing speculation over just where that location will be. Sources familiar with the planning tell CNN the Trump administration has sent scouting teams to multiple cities in different regions, including Asia, in recent weeks. One source says Bangkok, Thailand, Hawaii, and the Vietnamese capital Hanoi have been visited. If he flies long distance, analysts say, Kim would most likely have to borrow a Chinese plane, as he did when he flew to Singapore in June to meet with President Trump. Some experts say Kim's got a fleet of Cold War-era Soviet-made planes, which are poorly maintained and might be challenged with a long flight.
They're extremely old. They've been refurbished, but I wouldn't trust I mean, I flew on them because I had no choice. If he's got a choice, he should stay off of North Korean Airlines.
But Kim has been photographed on a presidential jet nicknamed Air Force Un, which some aviation experts say could make a long trip. Despite logistical and security concerns for the paranoid young dictator, some analysts believe Kim will venture far if it means another meeting with Trump.
Kim Jong-un would have concerns, but he needs the world stage because part of what he's doing is trying to help Donald Trump create theater, rather than take concrete steps at denuclearization. So he'll want a place where he can get media attention, but not a place, I think, where protests are possible, which would undercut his security and his propaganda message.
Now, wherever a summit is held, analysts say there is considerable pressure on both Trump and Kim Jong-un to come up with a more substantive deal than the one they struck in Singapore. Kim desperately needs sanctions to be lifted. Trump is facing more scrutiny on North Korea by newly empowered Democrats in Congress. Wolf, he's got to come back with something more substantive than they got in June.
Certainly true. Brian Todd reporting.